So this is my internship presentation, like everyone else's, so let's get into it. Quick overview, I never stood a chance. I was going to be an engineer. I was going to probably end up here no matter what I did, and I'll kind of explain why. Now, I'll talk about my time at the University of Arkansas, talk about my time last summer at TME LLC, kind of talk a little bit about here at Duke, what that, you know, has impacted me, and then kind of the unknown future that I wish was more known, but it's kind of part of the process. So it's the big part of, you know, where I'm headed, and so even though it's unknown, it's exciting. So never standing a chance. This is me. This is me. Very young, not too long ago, very young. And my dad was a civil engineer, and my mom was my elementary school principal. So when it came to doing math homework and like science homework assignments, they were getting done no matter what. One time my dad actually kind of let me skip out a little bit. They hand out the handwriting assignments to work on your penmanship, and those weren't as important as getting the addition and subtraction done. So I was pretty much destined not to be a writer, but to be an engineer. And with my mom as my principal, I wasn't allowed to get, you know, like 80s or anything on quizzes. If I, you know, before I got home, she would know about it and I would get spunk. And so I was just like, it's not worth it. It wasn't worth it. That's me being shocked and saying, okay, I'll be an engineer. So I went to the U of A, and it's the University of Arkansas, but it is the U of A. That is the official slogan, where they care about you once you've paid your tuition. So so at the U of A, I wanted to get into genetics and genetic engineering. That was my original plan. I loved the AP Bio in high school, loved the science, loved the idea of being able to cure diseases by kind of refitting bacteria and such organisms to kind of cure diseases instead of give them. Unfortunately, this is what your career looks like if you go into genetic engineering and biomedical engineering, that type of thing. And after doing one class of a lab, I realized I couldn't do it. I thankfully got partnered up with some great lab partners, two very technically sound students, two guys who loved all the technical work, who like could point out the name of every machine in here, but they hated writing. So we teamed up, they would do all the data analysis, they would get the end, they would tell me the results, and I would write it in all three of our lab books. It's teamwork, so it still counts. It's not cheating because we are on a team and we get one unified grade. But kind of that's kind of why I realized that, like we were supposed to line up the optics and stuff like that. And these kids were excited about it, and I was so confused. Why are you excited about this? Like, it's a Friday. We shouldn't be excited. So I was doing biomedical engineering, looking at genetics, and then I realized also it's also a PhD pretty much only track if you want to get to the highest level. And that's a lot of schooling. That's a lot of this. So I quickly decided, you know, what would I do that could kind of have the same impact, you know, genetic engineering? And that was make a lot of money. And so I switched to industrial engineering, which at the time, the CEO of Walmart is an industrial engineer bachelor's degree holder, and Tim Cook for Apple is also an industrial engineer. So it made sense. I would just do what they did, right? You begin doing industrial engineering and you make money. But in reality also, I like the business side more. That's what I realized. I kind of like working with people, selling myself, selling the ideas we were doing in those groups. So I thought, I'll go into business, I'll go into selling. But kind of once again, from my original photo, I was destined to kind of be an engineer, is I wanted to do economics and finance. And my dad is a civil engineer, says, well, there is kind of a business engineering, and you still have the word engineering in your degree. And I will, you know, love you still. But no, I mean, he would love me either way. But no, but that's kind of, I kind of got pushed that direction, and I'm glad I did. Because you learn a lot of skills that you could, you know, quickly then pick up the economics and kind of the finance. But if you, like some of my friends in the business college who never made it past calculus, like you miss some things by not doing engineering. So I decided that was what I was going to do, become an industrial engineer and make a lot of money, except for the fact that my senior year I realized I hated all the jobs that I applied for and got offers for, which is a heartbreaking thing to realize. Like, someone's like, hey, I'll give you this money, but you have to do something you absolutely despise. A little bit of moral dilemma. So, although I should have been like Nick and taking the money in retrospect with loans and debt and this program, I thought I did the right thing, and I was like, I'll apply to go to school and kind of transition to business where I can use my engineering skills. So I had to get an internship like we all did, and I got my acceptance letter in late April, and internships ended in early May. So I took the first thing that came to me, which was the TME LLC. And this kind of picture is a little crowded, and that's the point. It was very crowded for me. I would work for TME, who was a part of ASHE, which is the American Society for Healthcare Engineering. They built this kind of system, which I don't know what this is really still, for the University of Arkansas at Little Rock. And so I hop into the system. It's a multi-million dollar project where actually they use kind of the heating and chilling of a building, and they're going to revamp it and make it more energy efficient. And I thought, that's great. How can I help And they gave me blueprints of places like this. And after the first day where I accidentally highlighted the walls that I thought were piping, I realized once again technical things weren't really my strong suit. So kind of while I was at this internship, I was working with some people in the very technical issues, but I also got to spend a lot of time at the management meetings when all the different companies came together. Since they were working on a project with the University of Arkansas Little Rock, and all these people were associated with ASHI, that I got to go see a bunch of different companies. So TME was kind of my home base, but I got to go see the subcontractors, the general contractor. And I realized it was an internship that I liked the meetings more than I liked doing all the highlighting of the blueprints and the AutoCAD design. So TME was kind of my wake-up call of being in the real world. I was doing all the technical stuff, but for me just to do technical stuff for the sake of technical stuff drove me crazy. And thankfully there was a guy there who loved the technical stuff, and he kind of, he would give me a very, very small piece that was very simple. And he would make it sound like it was hard, and he'd be like, take a couple hours to do. And then my little office coworker told me that it shouldn't take me a couple hours, and that the other guy was just being nice to me. And so kind of like I said, it kind of steered me in the direction of knowing what I've always kind of known, is that I love people and that kind of thing more than sitting looking at a computer. But what I also learned there is that you need to know that kind of stuff as well. I knew some of the engineering terms. I knew I had actually taken thermodynamics. I'd put it off until my senior year, so I knew some of the terms. I, at that point, remembered the refrigeration cycle, so I could keep up in meetings. Like, oh, yeah, so you condense it next. I'm like, that's correct. I'm like, yes, bonus points. But so it is important to know all the technical stuff, but you don't have to be the expert in it, is what I learned there, because a lot of the guests at these meetings weren't experts. They knew just enough to get by, to tell the engineers, hey, design it, you know, it needs to be done. It needs to fit into this overall system. But as for, like, you know, the size of each one of these little bolts and stuff, they're like, do whatever you need to do engineering-wise. But they make sure that it fits into the larger system. And that's kind of where I realized that in management, like, part of our program is part of seeing the overall system. And so coming off that internship, I thought, where could I, you know, look at the overall system, be involved in that type of thing, and work with people? And I was really excited about my choice for MEM because I'm going to do consulting like everyone does, right? Like, that was my plan. Consulting, yeah, you see the salaries when they send out the employment sheet, you know, like they have very high salaries. I was excited. Consulting. And then I started talking to some of you and some of my friends who are actually working in consulting. And so I went to finance because that didn't sound so much fun. So I was like, let's go to finance. And then until about the end of last semester and the start of this semester, when I took an advanced financial engineering with Dr. Egger, I realized that's for people much smarter than me, like Dr. Egger and Talis. Like, that's them. No, that's not, like, for sure. That's why he's president of the finance club, and I'm not. Because they're talking about all this stuff, and I'm like, you mean to email someone? I can do that. Like, let me do that. So I thought finance, like, it's very interesting, but also not for me. And so I'm like, okay, engineering, really, no. Consulting, no. Finance, no. I'm running out of options. And then I kind of stepped back, and I thought, where can I work that's bigger picture, that's focused on people, and you can kind of use your technical systems knowledge to kind of dissect little pieces and parts. And so that's why I chose politics, also because, you know, also running out of options at the time. But no, I chose politics because in politics, you kind of, I feel like we need people with technical experience and technical backgrounds. There's a plethora of lawyers like Jeff, you know, who's amazing at teaching law, but even all the time says, well, actually, in law school, it's way more complicated. And that's kind of my problem. It's like helping people and, you know, going towards like a prosperous future shouldn't be so complex. You need 3 years of school. That when someone asks a question in one of our classes, he's like, well, actually, 10% of the time, you can maybe say this, or if it's a tort, it gets way too complicated. And I think we need like a systematic like engineering approach just to get it done, make it work, you know, instead of, well, you know, we need to make sure the stack of pages are this thick, that way they have something to quiz those kids on at MEM. Like, I think we should make it simple. So I'm trying to go into politics. It's a huge shift, but I'm really excited about it. As for the unknown future, I don't know what that looks like coming up to May now, you know, planning to graduate with consulting or finance degree. There are some jobs lined up. Not a lot of people from politics come from MEM, surprisingly. So the unknown future for me, I hope it's something like this. That would be great if I could do that. Or if I get an acting job, maybe. But no. I'm hoping it won't be that bloody or backstabberish, but that's the thing. I'm hoping that I could, you know, in that kind of way, use, you know, the popular rise of politics, you know, through House of Cards, to kind of get people involved in the future, you know, because a lot of kids like don't care about politics, but then there's a TV show about it now, and now it's kind of interesting. And I'm hoping to kind of ride that wave and say, hey, let's start paying attention to the things that affect all of us, and let's actually make a difference. And let's do it in an engineering way, where at the end of the day, we have something that actually works, instead of like a bunch of really complicated textbooks that keep lawyers employed. So that's kind of it. Please don't watch this, Professor Watkins or Professor Ward. But if you guys have any questions, I'd love to try to field them at this time.
So with politics, are you thinking more like running for office position or like public policy?
Right. All right. We should repeat the questions for this meter thing, for the recording thing. So the question was if I'm thinking, you know, running for office or public policy. Ideally, I would like to run for office. I started to do policy analysis type things, and a lot of it is the same engineering, kind of the grind and the details. And I enjoy that. I enjoy getting the result and thinking, what can we do with this? Kind of like with the machines, like, I didn't really care about those, like, boilers. I don't care how they work. But when someone tells me it costs this much to run and it gives you this much heat, I want to know how many can I use for my campus and how cost-efficient can I be and how can I, you know, get the most heat for the most money. And so that's kind of my overarching, you know, idea is to take kind of the technical approach of understanding a little bit how the pieces work. But once you have the pieces, what do you do with them? And I think running for office is kind of the best way for me to take the pieces, because there are a lot of people who are very passionate in like one very specific issue, whereas I see like the importance of like an interconnectivity of all the issues. I'm hoping to run for office and then hopefully use my love for very general things to kind of bring all those pieces together.
Left out the word for me, slide.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's very brave that, you know, you decide to do something so different and you follow what you want. But like my question is another thing. I wanted to know what are the.
I appreciate it, right? My parents call it foolish, but it's okay.
What is the path for becoming a politic? What are your next plans? What do you?
Okay. Yeah. No, that's great. Because it is a very huge shift. She asked kind of what are my future plans and how do I do that? So in February I took the law school entrance exam. Did decent enough on that to try to get into a school because I know there's like an influx of lawyers in the marketplace, so you try to get to a top 20, like a top one of those schools, and I think I stand a chance of getting in. And so my decision right now is kind of, do I apply to law school or do I apply to kind of a public policy? I'm speaking with some different people, spoken with Professor Watkins, going to speak with Professor Ward, kind of about that, in addition to maybe this summer trying to get an internship with either like a nonprofit or with actually a firm or someone in D.C. who works like directly with politics. But just kind of, you know, get my feet wet with that, and then maybe if necessary do like a small degree shift. But at the same time, if I get out there in the workplace maybe this summer or next fall and realize I don't need law school, but maybe, you know, public policy where I can learn the general stuff, I don't have to, you know, do the nitty-gritty of contracts and torts in addition, all that other stuff, then I'll probably go that way. But I've, just to be safe, I've taken the law school exam. The GRE is still good for public policy school, thankfully. So that's kind of that's part of the unknown. It's, I don't know which path to go, and I'm kind of just on a holding pattern until I can figure out what's the best route. That makes sense.
Elephant or donkey?
Depends. Which one are you guys voting more? No. I'm somewhere in the middle, probably more towards elephant, just because financially I think you have to have the money before you can do the great social programs. So that's kind of my idea is fiscal responsibility. If you know you have the money first, then you can do a lot of great things. If you don't have a lot of money, then you have more problems, you know, than the small things we like to fight about here in America, for sure. All right. Thank you.